Hello friends and welcome back to Haas of Props. As many of you know, I incorporate a lot of 3D printing into my prop making, and I recently been on the market trying to find a second printer to add to my studio. So I was looking around and I couldn't find exactly what I wanted, and then I remembered Elegoo, that I had seen a lot of their products being used by a lot of the big cosplayers. So I thought, okay, I'll take a chance with them because they have to be good if these big name people are using their products. So I bought the Neptune 2S. It has a similar print bed as what I've already used, and it's heated. It's a 220, 220 by 250 print area. So I figured I'm safe with this because it's relatively close to what I've been using. So let me show you how I assembled it, and let's do some test printing. So I just got the printer delivered, and the box doesn't look too beat up, so everything inside should be in good condition. Now let's get this thing open. While I open, go ahead and subscribe to this channel for more prop making content, and click the notification bell so you can be notified when a new video drops. Okay, well, it looks like everything is packaged really nicely with this high density foam. The manual looks clear and concise. We'll see in a minute if it actually is. And here we have the power cable. Some support bars. Now the print bed is attached to the bottom support, so let's go ahead and take out this whole layer of packing for now. The X-axis stepper. The X-axis slave unit. The Z-axis stepper, the power switch, more supports, and two bags with accessories and hardware. Okay, it looks like the bags are full of a variety of accessories, from a clog cleaner, snips, spare nozzles, a USB with SD card, filament, zip ties, all the hardware, Allen wrenches, screwdrivers, and wrenches. And that's not everything, there's still more in here. Like, even the Z-axis limit switch and the X-axis belt are in here. So let's begin putting it together. I start by removing the plastic wrapped around the bed. This is here to keep the bed from shifting during transport and when you're unpacking it. That way your bed's not flipping all around. The manual says to start by attaching the vertical supports onto the base with the HM5 45 screws. Each support is different, so make sure you follow the manual to make sure you have the holes and the supports in the correct orientation. Otherwise, things won't line up properly. To attach these is a little awkward. You have to turn the bed on its side, which I probably should have left that plastic on, but oh well, and send the screws up from the bottom. Then flip the whole thing and just repeat the same process for the other vertical support. Before you attach the power supply, flip the switch to what the power input is in your country. Then it can be mounted to the right vertical support with two HM4 20 screws.
Next, the Z-axis limit switch can be attached to the left support with two HM4 18 screws. The bottom edge of the switch wants to be about 5 millimeters above the base. The Z-axis stepper is screwed into the back of the left support with two KM4 20 screws. And the screw rod can be installed in the coupling, and then the tiny screws in the coupling can be tightened to hold it in place. The screw rod doesn't indicate which is the top and which is the bottom, so use the image in the manual as your reference in order to see what direction the threads run. Now it's time to assemble the movable horizontal support that holds the printer head. The X-axis stepper has screw heads that stick out the back. These want to align with the pre-drilled holes in the support. Then you want to feed two PM4 18 screws through the holes and use the hole drilled through the plate to tighten them with an Allen wrench. Now take the belt and thread it through the stepper, making sure the teeth are facing down, and align it with the gear that is inside the stepper. Wrap the belt around the opposite end and slip the printer head onto the bar. The printer head already comes attached to the bed, but you should have enough cable where you can assemble this without having too much difficulty. Then the belt can be slid through the X-axis slave unit, and then the unit can be attached to the bar with two P4 18 screws, but don't tighten them completely yet. Lock the ends of the belt onto the belt chutes on the bottom of the printer head, then make sure the X-axis slave unit has the belt under tension before locking it in place. Then the bar can be slipped over the vertical supports and onto the screw rod. Now tighten the screws on the X-axis stepper where the rod comes through. This will keep the rod from wobbling when printing. Then the top bar can be attached with four HM5 25 screws. This bar helps to keep the vertical supports aligned and tight so your printer head can move more smoothly. The filament tube can be attached to the filament holder, and then this can be mounted to the top of the horizontal support. Nearing the last steps of assembly, we can now plug everything together. The manual has a clear diagram as to what goes where, and the wires are clearly labeled on the printer with little tags. The final step is to push the PTFE tube into the extruder stepper and secure it by pressing one of the blue C-clips onto the plug. Now it's time to plug in the power cord and switch the unit on. Well, it came on, so that's a good sign, and there's the menu. The manual has a detailed step-by-step outline of how to level the bed, so I'm not going to waste your time by showing you how to do that here. After a couple of attempts, I managed to get the test print that comes on the SD card to adhere to the bed and to print. And the printer is the quietest I've ever heard. Here, listen. That's literally all the noise it makes when it's printing. A little over an hour later, and the test print is finished. I'm really happy with the level of detail, and I can't wait to print one of my props on this thing. So now I want to show you some of the features about this thing that I really like. This menu is a touch screen. It's really easy to navigate. It's simple to use. You just hit the buttons. It's much better than the dial. You can find things relatively easy. It's super nice. Okay. The bed is a metal bed. It's got a slight flex to it, but it's metal. It's magnetic. It adheres to the plate, and it's got a great texture to it so that the prints stick really easily to this thing. So it's great that it's metal. Everything else I've had has been like a plastic with a magnet on the bottom, and this surface is just great. I think my favorite feature is this little doohickey right here. This thing senses the filament coming through And if it, for some reason, like your filament snaps or you run out of filament, it will detect that there's no filament being used and push through the extruder, and it will literally pause your print and you can just pick up right where you left off. That is great, because that's been my big fear with large prints, is that they run out. The leveling dials on this thing are metal, which is much better than the plastic, because there's a bit of, you can get a better grip on them with that texture than you can with a Crayolti. And to level this thing, it's super easy. You go to into the settings and hit level, click the point, and it will automatically move your printer head to the first location so that you can start to level this thing without needing to worry about its location. It's lowering the head right now because it was still up from where I had printed the test print. But it lowers it into the 0 point position, raises it up, and then moves it over to the first point and back down. And now you can turn the dial and adjust the height at that point. And then when you're done, all you have to do is go back to your menu, hit point two, it'll raise it back up, take it to the next point, lower it, and then you just repeat the process again of leveling, which this is great. You don't have to worry about, is the head in the right position? It finds that position for you. So I am really happy with this printer. This is a really good upgrade, I think.
And there you have it. And I have to say, I believe I'm a new Elegoo convert. The print quality is phenomenal. Setup, assembly, and printing on this printer is super easy. And I printed a piece from one of my upcoming projects on it. And again, I am super happy with the quality that it turned out. I highly recommend you check out Elegoo if you haven't already. And please, give this video a thumbs up, share it with friends and family, and subscribe to House of Props.
And remember, if you are building any of my builds or using any of my templates, feel free and tag me at House of Props on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok, because I would really like to see your fantastic work. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.